When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness?
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to Episode 8 of The Creators. Today's episode is one that, like me, shares a social stigma around the MTG community. And like myself, he works hard to move past this stigma, but it still follows him. More recently, an outrage mob has managed to get him kicked off of the much-anticipated War of the Spark for the early release on MTG Arena. For something that, if it is related to, happened over a year ago. This creator, who also hails from Canada, yes, that's right, a fellow polar bear rider who also has a conceal and carry for a stapler. This is Cindershad0w. Cinder's spark for MTG began like mine in late 1993, early 94, but for him, it was more of a thing that, you know, he really never got into until about high school. When, like the rest of us, we were old enough to know how to play, understand how to play, and with enough convincing from our friends, got us to play. For him, this has turned into a lifelong hobby, an escape that has now evolved into content creation. Cinder uses this content creation as a means to help him cope with being off work. With a young child at home that requires constant care, both him and his wife are required to stay at home and take care of baby Cinder. But this content creation has not gone unnoticed. There is a 250 unique people who watch Cindershad0w. He's always active in the community, and he has collaborations with a lot of personalities, some big ones like Desolator Magic, and some new ones like Opening Hand. While some of the co-creators that he mingles with also have some stigma associated with them, this has also had its negative effects, which was further highlighted when he joined the Magic the Gathering Content Creators group on Facebook. Almost immediately after stating his name, he was attacked for who he watched and who he followed, being called a drone and an NPC. But he didn't lash out. He stayed reserved, calm. And we got that settled. And it kind of shows how inclusive this community can be. Like me, Cinder prefers to hang around in the background because it's safer. It is for all of us. However, he can be outspoken, and everyone should be, or as everyone should be, when they see something that they view as reprehensible. Cinder views his top fans as being his Patreons, people who support him regularly. While this doesn't preclude people who visit, share, like, and subscribe, he feels that these would be the highlights of content creation. This has led Cindershad0w to create a lot of videos. He live streams every night. Doesn't matter what it is, whether it's Magic the Gathering, Final Fantasy, or Dead Space. Which means I really don't have to show any pictures or videos or anything, because you can go see it for yourself. It would mean a lot if you would pop by. I'll put the link in below. Just say hi, or help him reach his 1,000 subscriber goal if you like his content. There's a little bit for everyone. As I previously stated, there's gameplay videos from various games. There's some deck techs, both in arena and out. He has his own little series about gaming news, This Week in Magic. His main goal with all of this is to have fun, and to encourage others to do the same. Well, we all use content creation for our own ways and our own means. Cinder had stated that his content creation is a major source of de-stressing. I, for one, don't view it that way. Video editing can be quite stressful. Trying to get those little clips together perfectly, like my Battle Bond video, timed perfectly, but that took a long time. So I don't see personally how that would be de-stressing, but Cinder does. Uses it as a mean of escape. For example, he told me that in the late 90s and early 2000s, there was a major life-changing event that happened. He contemplated suicide. It was the death of his grandmother, for whom he was the closest. This woman raised him, because his mother could not. And after she passed away, he was faced with homelessness, bouncing around from place to place. His mom was not in a place to help him. But he got there. Got a job at 18, got an apartment. And instead of turning to drugs, he turned to Magic the Gathering and Dungeons and Dragons, which is a good means of coping. While it is a fantasy world, it's not drugs. And drugs, coming from a personal experience, is an easy way out. I have a lot of family members who are addicts, and it's not fun. So I can see how the silver lining of turning to a fantasy world would help one cope. Because I was there too. My father passed away when I was 9, and I had a choice to make. It was to do and sell drugs, or to do the honorable thing and be the best person I know myself to be. And I too turned to fantasy world, video games, card games. And in the end, here we are. Friends to one another. Not just Cinder and I, but anyone who watches. Today, Cinder has beaten the odds. Lives with a wife and a son, who, like me, can't wait for him to be old enough to teach Magic the Gathering. I'm going the more slower route, though. I'm teaching my son Yu-Gi-Oh! Because it can be reduced to simple adding and subtracting, whether or not the creatures have special abilities. And I suppose that could be true with Magic the Gathering. And it's this kind of dedication to the community that no matter what comes out of it, no matter how much we're attacked or how people view us, it's that we know with ourselves that we're satisfied, that we've done what we thought is best. Hi, I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Roundtable and CEO of TPS Gaming. If you liked today's video, feel free to drop a comment, click like, and subscribe. To be notified of the next upload or livestream, don't forget the bell. It's 2019 and we have a lot in store for you, like affiliations with the following. Inked Gaming, a leader in customizable gaming supplies, from mouse pads and dice bags, table mats, and binders. Use promo code THEFILTHYCAS at checkout to receive 10% off your order. As an added bonus, receive free shipping on all orders over $75. A portion of sales benefits the channel. And Everything Games, Langford's premium gaming and hobby shop, carrying everything from Magic Gathering, Warhammer, Attack, Linky Forge, and much more. Online sales can be found at www.everythinggames.ca. I would like to thank the current patrons, but without you, I would not be able to keep this lights on. And remember, shop at your local game store. They are the foundations of the gaming community. Without them, none of us would have a place to play. Thanks for watching. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual.